नेक्स्ट टॉपिक लॉरेंस लॉरेंस फोर्स इक्वेशन. सो एक्चुअली एज वी नो दैट दिस इज अ फोर्स इक्वेशन. सो फोर्स ड्यू टू इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो हियर वी हैव टू कंसीडर बोथ द फील्ड आर प्रेजेंट. इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड आर प्रेजेंट एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द फोर्स ऑन चार्ज ड्यू टू दिस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो दैट इज वाई लॉरेंस फोर्स इक्वेशन इज नथिंग बट इट्स अ टोटल फोर्स इक्वेशन. एफ टी मीन्स इट्स अ टोटल फोर्स इज इक्वल टू फोर्स ड्यू टू इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड फोर्स ड्यू टू मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो नाउ लेट अस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कंसिडर फोर्स ड्यू टू द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. ओके सो हियर आई टू जस्ट कंसिडर ए वन चार्ज प्लस क्यू वन. दिस चार्ज इज ए स्टेटिक चार्ज एंड हैज बीन नो दैट इफ द चार्ज इज स्टेटिक चार्ज सो इट जनरेट ए इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो दिस ग्रीन कलर लाइन इज इंडिकेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. ओके सो नाउ द फोर्स बिटवीन Q1 and Q2 charge Fe is equals to, as we know that the equation is when Q2 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. And what is the electric field intensity of this first charge? E1 is equals to Q1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. And if we have to combine these two equations, so finally we will get the force due to electric field Fe is equals to Q2E. Okay, so in generalize we can write force due to electric field Fe is equals to QE. Okay, so here we get first what is Fe. Fe is force due to electric field on charge Q. F is equals to QE. And as we know that the force is a vector quantity, so Fe vector is equals to Q into E vector. Now let us discuss about the next force, which is Fm, magnetic force. Okay, so now let us discuss about the magnetic force on charge. So here I would just draw this is a magnetic field B. Okay, this is a magnetic field. Okay, and here first of all we have to consider this plus Q charge is a static charge. Okay, so now I have to apply a force on this charge in this direction. So charge is move in this direction. That means the charge has a certain velocity in this direction. Okay, so here I have to just consider this dash line separate the two region. This region has magnetic field and this region has no magnetic field. That is, no magnetic field is present in this region. So whenever the charge, this moving charge, why the charge is moving? Because I have to apply a force on this charge in this direction. So if the charge is entering, this plus Q charge is entering in this magnetic field. Okay, now you can just imagine the charge is entering in the magnetic field. Okay, so now it experiences some force due to the magnetic field B. In which direction? So we will discuss about it. So now the charge is rotating in nature. Okay, so charge डायरेक्टली ये डायरेक्शन में मूवमेंट नहीं करेगा, स्ट्रेट डायरेक्शन में मूवमेंट नहीं करेगा, लेकिन चार्ज की मूवमेंट क्या होगी? रोटेटिंग मूवमेंट हो जाएगी. ओके सो इट इंडिकेट्स वेलोसिटी ऑफ चार्ज. ओके दिस डायरेक्शन इज इंडिकेट द वेलोसिटी ऑफ चार्ज. ओके एंड दिस वन इज अ डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. ओके दिस ऑल आर द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. ओके सो इन विच डायरेक्शन द फोर्स इज एक्सर्टेड ऑन द चार्ज? Okay, the force is exerted on the charge which is a perpendicular of velocity as well as the magnetic field. Okay, so we can write force due to this magnetic field is Q, this is the value of charge, velocity of charge V cross B. Okay, so this is the equation of magnetic force on charge. But the condition is this charge must be a moving charge. This charge must be a moving charge. That means charge ki movement honi chahiye. If, okay, now the most important statement, if charge Q is not moving charge, that means if it is fixed. So what happen? Agar charge ki movement nahi hoti hai, to uski velocity kitni hogi? Zero. So if velocity is zero, so if I have to put V is equals to zero, so what is the magnetic force in that case? The magnetic force is zero. Okay, so magnetic force is applicable only on moving charge, not a fixed charge. But what about electric force? Electric force is applicable on fixed charge as well as moving charge. Okay, so finally, we can conclude that the total force Ft is equals to Fe plus Fm is equal to Qe vector, which is Fe is equals to Qe, plus what is Fm? Fm is Q in bracket V cross B, where V is velocity and B is magnetic field. Okay, so if I will take Q as a common, so it is E plus in bracket V cross B. Okay, fine. But here, this is the first condition. The first condition is Q is moving. Okay, this Q is moving charge. Now, second condition. In a second condition, the total force is, again, is the addition of electric field force plus magnetic field force. But if this is a second condition, if charge Q is fixed, then what happened? This magnetic force is zero. So we can write only QE because this magnetic force is zero. Okay, so answer is the total force is only due to the electric. Okay, so this equation is called as Lorentz force equation. This equation is called as the Lorentz force equation.